Hello, and welcome to my Minecraft 1.8 tutorial. This is episode number 6 in my How to Survive and Thrive series. And in today's episode, we are going to move out of the hidey hole and into a real home. A home made of wood and stone. It'll have a floor and walls and a roof, even. And windows and doors. Oh my, can you imagine? We're going to finally get out of that dark, dingy, stinky cave. Because we're not cavemen. Do I look like a caveman to you? Don't answer that. Alright, let's get started, shall we? We're going to go build this thing right down there. It's called a cozy cottage. It's a small, lovely little house. Shouldn't take too long. It's not very difficult to make. Even a caveman could do it. But first, I want to put a beacon here, guys, because I haven't put any beacons up yet. And what this beacon is for is if you ever go off in a particular direction and get lost in the woods, say, and you're not sure how to get back home, you can just look up in the sky. You might see this beacon from afar and go, oh, that's where I live. So I like to put those around now and then. You can, of course, just use the coordinate system, which is, yeah, maybe a little more sensible. But I'm old school, you see. We didn't have these F3 buttons back in the day. We had to make dirt beacons. All right, let's get on down here. Enough of that grumpy old man stuff. And let's get building this thing, because it ain't gonna build itself, as they say. So this is, again, the cozy cottage. This is an old design, goes back to 2011, something I have been building for quite some time. I love it. It was originally designed by a gentleman by the name of Leo Stereo, which I found on the Minecraft forums. I'll put a link to that down below to give him full credit. I will modify this somewhat, but it is his design originally. And we are going to build it right here. This is where we shall break ground, but we can't break ground yet. So we have to clear this land, and we have some things to do beforehand. And for example, put our helmet on our lovely noggin so it doesn't get dented. It's already dented enough. And first things first, we're going to make a workbench. We're going to plop that down, and we're going to get some of this stone. As you can see here, I've already made, I've done some off-camera work. I've dug up some cobblestone. Plenty of cobblestone around. If you guys want to follow along, just go ahead and do that. You're going to need a few stacks. And we're going to make some furnaces. And by the way, if you want to follow along with this particular map, you certainly can. There's a link down below in the description. Just download the map and you'll be right here with all these goodies ready to roll. So we're going to put down some furnaces right here. We're going to get them cooking up some stuff. And I want to show you guys a quick trick here. If I want to place a furnace on top of another furnace, for example, or on top of anything that can be interacted with in Minecraft, like a workbench, you have to hold down the shift key. Okay, because Minecraft is thinking you want to open it up, which I don't. I just want to plop it on top. Huzzah. Pretty cool stuff. Nice little tip there. All right, we're going to break up our coal into units of 4-ish. Actually, I don't even need to do that. We're going to put 4 in here. We're going to take our cobble and dump it in there, and you can see that is now being burned. Go figure. Burning stone. And we're going to put some in there. We're smelting it down into stone brick. Because stone brick is something that... Actually, we're going to smelt it down into smooth stone, I should say. Smooth stone is the stuff that you mine right there and get cobblestone from, in fact. So it's like reverse engineering the stone, isn't it? Kind of odd, but that's the way it works. It's Minecraft. So what we're looking for is at least 4 of these right now, and I'll show you a quick demonstration of how to get stone bricks, which is basically just 4 of these smooth stones, and you get 4 stone bricks back. It's a 1-for-1 yield, if my math is correct, and that's what that looks like. It's lovely indeed, isn't it? And we're going to use that in the build. So I don't need that right now. It's going to poop that away. We're going to plop that away. I'm going to poop it away. That could hurt. So let's let that cook up, and in the meantime, we have some things to do. We need to clear this land and then get some more wood. So what we're looking for, because I want to make this with birch. So we're going to get lots of birch. We're going to need probably about 32, actually more than that. If we're going to make, you know what, we're going to clear all these trees out. We'll see how much we need in the long run. I'll probably grow some in between. And also some of this dark oak wood. This is something that I've not ever built with, is this dark oak wood, and I want to get some of this too. I would say 32 of these dark oak planks, right, logs. And I like to not destroy all of the trees, so I like to take a little bit from each one. Oh, and also get 8 sand. Now, I know I could have done this off camera and had all this ready, but I like to do this from start to finish. I like to do the whole thing with you guys to show you everything. That's the whole point of this as being a tutorial, so that new players can understand what to do. Because sometimes you don't know. If you already show up with stuff, they're like, how did he get that? Hey, look, my beacon! That's where I live. Oh, right, I'm moving. Thank you for reminding me. So go ahead and do that. Clear that land, get some birch, and get about 32 of these dark oak wood, and I'll meet you back at the dig site. So stay tuned, be right back. Wow, back so soon? Okay, let's see if you get everything I sent you for. You got some dark oak wood? Check. You got some birch wood? Check. You didn't forget your sand, did you? Good! Man, you are awesome! I knew I picked you guys for this job for some reason. Alright, let's put 8 sand in this special furnace down here, and that is going to smelt down into glass. So while waiting for that, we're going to go ahead and grab our stone, smooth stone out of these other furnaces, and we're going to start converting everything down into building materials that we're going to use in our cozy cottage. So as I had said before, we need the stone brick, just like that. Lovely things indeed. And we're going to grab these two fellows over here because we need you. And we are also going to convert our birch wood down into planks. And we're going to take some of these planks and turn them into... Hello, piggy. Into about 48... Good morning to you too, sir. Slabs, just like that. And that should be enough. We are going to need some stairs. I'm not sure how many yet, so we're going to hold off on that. But we're going to use the birch for the flooring and the rooftop. And these we're going to convert a couple down, but I'm not sure exactly how many. Well, let's just do those for now. And we want these dark oak wood raw tree trunk as is. Good. Okay. Whew. We're cruising now, guys. All right. It's time to break ground. Piggy, get the champagne. Never mind. All right. Here we go. It's going to be 8x6. Like I said, it's kind of a small thing, but small things come in big packages. Or something like that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Who do we appreciate? Piggy! Piggy! Go, Piggy! Where's my champagne, yo? What? The squiddy drank it? fun stuff. Okay, 8, 6 back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 8x6, right? According to my calculations, this would be correct. Now all we have to do is make our rectangle. And then get rid of all the dirt in the center. Oh, by the way, we're going to go down 3. 1, 2, that's 3. So 1, 2, 3, hop in the hole. Whoops, I missed. Bonk. And now we're just going to clear this whole hole out. The whole hole and nothing but the hole. This is the basement, you see? We'll go ahead and dig out all that dirt. And when you're done, come on back. Ha, beat ya. All right, 6x8, we're done here. Now I had to leave a little dirt because I forgot to make my ladders. So let's go make my ladders. You can't do this without ladders. We're going to have 3 ladders leading out the back. That's all you need is 3. There we go. Never send a pig to do a man's job, is what Mama always said. Or maybe that was Papa. I can't remember. It's been so long now. That's why I forgot. That's why I sent a pig to do a man's job, because I forgot. All right, ladders in the back here, folks. 1, 2, and 3. I'm sorry. No, you go. You go now. We don't need you here. All right, we don't need that guy. Actually, no, get those ladders back. I'm sorry, ladders. You know, I'm not ready for you. We gotta put the basement down. We don't want a dirt basement, do we? It's not a root cellar after all. We're gonna put in our foundation, guys. So let's do this. It's gonna be a stone foundation. Lovely, lovely stone. Go ahead and fill all this in with stone. And in fact, you know, you could do this. Let's just get rid of some of this dirt. We don't need the dirt. I don't know why I had you guys dig out that last bit of dirt down here. We could have actually left this like so. And then just put the stone up top here. So my bad. This is an old design, you see? This is how I used to make it. And I haven't really improved upon it much. But you can leave those little holes in the corners here. You can have like a little secret stash. You can stash your secret stuff. Whatever that is. I won't tell anyone. Now that I know about it. And that's it. Like that. Huzzah. We could get this cobblestone back. I could probably use it, so let's just do that. Bunk, 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 bunk. Okay, great. Now, where's the front? Front, front, that's the front. Okay, so in the back over here, we're going to put the ladder. And we're going to put 2 ladders like so. Okay, so we can get the heck out of here when we need to. If a creeper jumped in here, we is a goner, just to let you know. And we're going to put down our flooring now. So we're going to use these... No, you could use, if you wanted to use oak down here, you could, to save on the birch, but since we already made the birch, I guess it's too late for that now. Oops. Oh boy. Anyway, let's just go ahead and put in our flooring. And let's make sure we can put stuff down on this, because I always forget. You gotta put the slab on the high piggy on the top of the block so that you can place stuff down on top of it. If you put the slab on the bottom of this block that you're placing it on, you can't put stuff on top of it. See what I mean there? There we go. Okay, but you don't belong there, so skedaddle. Alright, now we got some holes here, don't we? Oh, this is your secret stash. Guess what? Well, I guess you can still have one block secret stash, right, Piggy? Right, there we go. Boom. I missed. Okay, let's take our dark oak wood planks. Lovely, aren't they? Sure, indeed. And we're gonna... Whoa, watch it! I'm sorry. Oh, no, no, no. No, 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 no. No Piggy in... No. Now look what you've done. See? You... Okay, you stay. I'll get you out later. Or not. We're gonna put in these corner posts. And these are the lovely dark oak wood. And then we're going to fill in everything in between them. Well, except for the front with the cobble. This, again, is our basement foundation. We're going to save these two right in the center because we're going to use wood there instead. That's going to be the front walk, stoop, whatever you want to call it. What do you call a piggy? I don't speak pig. I'm sorry. Maybe that's why you didn't get the champagne. He doesn't know what the heck I'm saying. There we go. Boom. Just like that. We'll fill that up. And then we're going to put in the rest of the flooring here inside the inside the home. And I am thinking we're going to use these slabs since we got them anyway. We might as well. You can use full-size blocks if you like. But you get a better yield if you use the slabs. And you get a little more headroom too. Check it out, pig. Look at this. Look at that headroom. What do you think? Look at me up and down. Look at him. Come on. Stand up. Get tall. Good things come in small packages. That's the word I was looking for. The saying. Not small things come in big packages. All right, so we'll see you later, pig. I guess I have a pet pig now. That's going to be fun. Forever and ever. Down in my bedroom. So let's go ahead and make a trap door. And a trap door is quite simply six planks, according to my calculations. Again, math is not my strong point. It is for the week, after all. And we're going to put this trap door right here. And that gives us access in and out. And yes, indeed, I appear to have a pet pig. And put that away. I didn't want you as a pet anyway. Dang, fool. What was that? Oh, no, I already made those. Right, okay. So now, let's just make a little space here, guys. I think we're done with the cobble, most of it anyway. And, oh, dang it. Look at this. Rain, dark, dangerous. And, okay, I think I'm going to go to bed in hidey hole right now. Pig, you okay down there? Hey! I think he's fine. Hi. Yeah, you stay down there. I'll close up the hatch. You should be fine. I'll go sleep in my hidey hole. I'll be back in the morning. Good night. I'll see you guys in the sunshine. Whoa, creeper. Be right back. Don't go away. All right, back at the construction site. Let's check on Piggy. Hi, Piggy Wiggy. How you doing down there? Everything okay? Doesn't look like the basement flooded, so I guess we did something right. All right, let's go convert the rest of the materials here, guys, and let's get this thing done. So what do we need now? We are going to need some stairs for the roof, and I think we're going to need more than that, dude. So why don't we go ahead and just do like, oh, I don't know, 32 ought to do. We may have to come back to make more later, but I think that's a good start. We are also going to make the front stoop with this dark oak wood plank. So let's go ahead and we are going to do some fencing. So to make fencing, I think we did this in one of the earlier episodes, didn't we? It's just like that. And we're going to need, I think, we're going to need four. So I'm going to have to make six. And by the way, now with 1.8, we can make different colored fence. We can never do this before. So you guys got it easy these days. Back when I was a kid, we could only make... Oh, black, 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 black. Anyway, now we have all these beautiful colors, and I'm very excited about that. You know what? We can make more of these, too, because what we want to do is make... I think we need a couple of stairs. Again, the front stoop is going to be dark oak wood, and I've never done this before with the dark oak, so we'll see how this looks. I think the light birch and the dark oak is going to look pretty nice, if you ask me. Oh, we're going to need some doors, too, so we might as well make them now. Let's make birch doors. What do you say? We'll try out the birch. That ought to look pretty. And I think that's it. Oh, you know what? I think I wanted to use... Oh, dang it. I think I wanted to use... Let's make the fence. I'm going to try both. Now, you guys can try either as well and see how it works out for you. You'll see what I'm going to do here in a moment. So we're just gathering the goods. Okay, let's go. Ooh. Ooh. Front lawn needs a little help here. Let's just put this here so we can see how things look. And we also need some scaffolding for this. And okay. All right, here we go. So I want to put down some... we're going to put stairs down here in the front. Again, this is the front stoop. And we're going to put some dark oak here, just regular planks. And I think... well, let's put the walls up next so that we can actually have this stuff attached to something. So now we're going to raise up these corner frame pieces, the dark oak. Let's go up. I'm going to go up a total of 4, 2, 3, 4. Actually, you can go 5. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Piggy, you want to stay with me? Out. No, I guess not. 2, 3, 4, 5. Piggy? Out. Up. It was a little too quick. And let's eat so we can heal up. Two broken ankles now. Not fun. All right, so now we're going to take our stone brick here. Then we're going to put it down all along the flooring. This is the lower part of the wall. Lovely, lovely stone brick. And then we're going to look up top here, and we're going to go across. Some people call it a crossed. Whoops, I missed. It's not crossed, it's a cross. And now we're going to get this guy, because he doesn't belong there. And we do the same thing across the top here. So you're going to have that one little nub sticking up. See there? And I hope we have enough stone brick. I did make tons and tons, didn't I? All right. Now, we are going to fill in some of these walls here, too. I'm just wondering how we want to do the... I think we're going to put the glass in here. Let's go grab the glass, in fact, right now. So we have 8 glass blocks. And we're going to convert these into panes. And it's quite painless, you see. That's all you have to do. Painless. Get it? Pain. So we're going to put our windows in. And this is kind of to taste. You can either do, say, like one big window here like that. And then the two in the corners up for the front. You have to do that because we're going to have a double door in front. Or you can do maybe something like this to have the windows in the corner. It's really up to you. I usually do it like that with the corner windows, but I think this time around I want to try like so. Cool. And then in the back I usually do something. No. Piggy agrees. No. Yes, like that. Okay, I like to have a lot of light here in the back, so we'll do that. And we'll throw in our windows. Now, you know, keep in mind that once your window is in, if you want to get it back out, you have to break it. And it goes bye-bye. And mom might get mad if you break the windows. All right, let's put in the doors. Ooh, I like. Very, very nice indeed. Now we can put this on this side or from the inside, and we'll have a little bit of space in front. We'll try it both ways. How about that? Let's build a stoop. So the stoop is going to look like this. And then we're going to put a cover up on top, but we need some scaffolding. And that's where the dirt come in, you see. Then we're going to do our pillar right up. Boom, boom, boom. And now we're going to need some of these guys. Got an extra door here. Let's put the dark oak wood. I'm trying to figure out the most efficient way to do this. Let's put the dark oak wood here in front. Like that. Because we have to put stairs in now. And I want the roof is going to be this. The birch stair. But I need to have a solid base here for the stoop. Alright. So now we're going to take these stairs. And we're going to put a stair right up on top of that. And then on top of that, give it kind of a pointed effect. Or something like that. I don't know what I'm talking about. And Piggy, stop agreeing with me. And like that. Okay, how's that look? Now we could change those out to make that the birch, but I'm not really sure. Trying different things here. Getting creative. Hard to say. Now, what we could do is throw in some slabs right there. Let's try this. I'm thinking maybe some slabs. We never had slabs back in the old days. Yeah, that looks pretty. I like it. All right, that's excellent, guys. Good work. Yeah, I think I'm going to change those out with the birch. Yeah, I do believe. And it looks like we're going to need more stairs. So let's make more stairs. This is for the roof. Let's get back on up there. Where's my scaffolding at? Now, you can play around with this if you like and try different designs and different styles and colors of woods. I just decided to go with this dark and light together. There we go. And I think I'll just put that down there. Actually, you know what you could do? Hey, hold the phone, everybody. This is something new. See, we never had this in the old days either. We never had stairs that could bend time and space. Oh, yeah. I like it. Okay. Time and space bent. What do you know? Now we are going to need some more of this. Because it looks like we have to go up one more. Is that right? Boy, it's been a while. Let me check my notes. The notes say, Paul, you on the right track. Go for it. So we're going to fill this in with some stone brick. And ow! Okay. Scaffolding, please. By the way, I'm actually using the diagram from the Minecraft annual, 2014 annual that I made this thing for. It's a printed book that Egmont did. Same people that did the strategy guide that I contributed to as well. So it's got nice pictures and everything. I wrote it all up. Looks nice. Anyway, okay, so there we go. So that part's done. No rain. Bad rain. Go away. Why you rain? Oh, boy. All right, I guess we could finish this in the rain, but you know what? I don't like the way that looks in the video. So I'm going to go back to bed and get reorganized, and I'll be right back. You guys can come back, too, when I'm back. So hang tight. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back, and this time I brought my bed. So if we get rained on again, we can just sleep right here in the cozy cottage for the first time. And look what we have here. We have a zombie trying to get across the moat. This is what I love about this river. And they're nice and slow and easy to shoot. Goodbye, zombie. All right, now let us finish this off. All we need now is a ceiling in cozy cottage and then finish up the roof. And we'll be good to go. Now, I did note that I made a kind of a boo-boo in the back. We have to remove some of the stone off the back top of the wall, which we'll go do as soon as we get up there. We also need 12 stone slabs, and I'll show you where those are going to come in handy here momentarily. Let's go put the bed away right now, in fact, so we have a spawn point, and get down here to the basement. Hello, pig! Did you miss me? Here, have some light. I feel so badly, I forgot about the light for you. There you go. Well, you know what? You did jump in there. It's your own dang fault, you dang fool. Sleep in the bed you make, piggy. Or don't be sleeping in my bed. It's my bed. If I catch him in my bed, he's dead. He's pork chops. All right, let's put in the ceiling. So I'm going to use full blocks here because it makes the house a little cozier. If you go up too high with slabs, it just feels like it's big cathedral ceilings. And it's not nearly as cozy, at least in my opinion. So I like the full blocks here. There we go. Lovely. And now this is the mistake I was referring to. And we're going to have to take these guys out. Stop you. Don't you criticize me, pig. It's been a long time since I've made this. And he's laughing at me down there. So just get rid of those. No big deal. And then... Oop, forgot somebody. And then we're going to put the stairs here as the roof. Whoopsie! And this is always fun to do these angles. That's sarcasm, folks. It's not fun. Not fun at all. There we go. And boom. Boom chaka-laka-laka. No! See? And jump and skip and hop and done. All right. Let us get the rest of the gear here. We're going to need... I think we might need some more stone brick. Let's just do that. And I think we are ready. Get rid of the stakeums. All right. And we don't need any more of those. We're good. Okay, so here's what we do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Raise this up just a little bit. That's going to give us our peaked roof. And now, for the grand finale, we just finish up the stairs on the rooftop. And that makes a nice roof, you see. Whoopsie. Well, that's going to leak. Let's make sure we put these in right. If you point toward the bottom of the stairs, it usually works just fine, but not always. Watch this move. See that? A back jump. Nah! All right, stop showing off and just do it right. There we go. And we'll do the same thing here, of course. So I think you get the idea. Very, very simple. We have this bit of a loft up here, too. So if you want to move up here, you can. Not much headroom. You have to lay down, but you can... figure something out. We might expand this someday and make it a little larger. There we go. And it's not done yet. Hold on. Let's make sure we have enough of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have enough. It's math, folks. It's math. It works. It matches. We're done. This is great. And we did it all in like, what, 25 minutes, I think? Roughly, thereabouts. It's the first. I've never done this in less than like 50 minutes. So I'm getting better. Look at that. Isn't it lovely? Yes, it is. Now let's go all the way around and make sure we didn't screw anything up. I think we got it right. Yep, looks mighty fine. And that, my friends, is the Cozy Cottage. Once again, original design by Leo Stereo. And I'm going to put a link to his post on the Minecraft forums. It's really old, but it's still there. And you can go tell him thank you for this awesome design. And if you want to download this map before we get started, you can. I'll put a link down below in the description for that as well. And as always, folks, I hope you enjoy this episode. And with that, I'm going to go in to my new cozy cottage. And we're going to have to do something with lighting and decorating, but we'll deal with that another time. And that's it for now. I'm going to stand here in my foyer, my front foyer, and say goodbye. Let's take off the helm and do this proper-like by swinging a shovel at you. No. Okay, there we go. Goodbye. We'll see ya. Hope you enjoyed. Bye-bye.